In the following lessons, we will learn how to create basic solid objects. In this lesson, I will show you how you can create boxes and cylinders. In the open file, I have created a box and a cylinder. These shapes are usually used in combination with other solids to create more complex objects. Now I will show you how you can create those solids. Let's start with a box. First, I need to activate the box tool. So I will click on the box icon, which can be found in the modeling panel of the home ribbon. Alternatively, I could have typed box in the command line and pressed enter. When the command is active, AutoCAD displays the message specify first corner, so I will click on a random point to define it. Then, another message prompts me to specify the other corner. Again, I will click on a random point to define the opposite corner. In the last step, I have to specify the height of the box. I can click to define the height randomly, or I can type the exact height and press enter. So, this time, I will type 2 and press enter. In this way, I created a box. I can also create a box by defining its center first. To do that, I will activate the box tool and select the center option from the command line. Now, I will click on a random point in the drawing area to define the center of the box, and then I will click again to define the corner of the box. In the next step, I have to specify the height. Notice that as I move the cursor, the height changes proportionally in both directions of the Z axis. To define the height, I will type 2 and press enter. Notice that the command was deactivated automatically. With the box tool, I can also create cubes easily. To create a cube, I will activate the box tool once more, and I will click once to specify its first corner. Now, instead of clicking again to define the other corner, I will select the cube option, which can be found in the command line. Since the cube's width, length, and height are the same, all I need to do is define one of them, and the cube will be created. So I will click to define a random length, and notice that the cube is created. Alternatively, I could have typed the exact length and pressed enter. I should mention that if you want to create a box of certain dimensions, you have to type the values for the length, the width, and the height respectively. So, I will activate the box tool again, and I will click to define the first corner. Then, I will click on the length option that appears in the command line, and I will type 4 and press enter to define it. Then I will type 3 to define the width and press enter again. Finally, I will type 3 to define the height and press enter. Notice how easily I created a box with specific dimensions. In the following examples, I will show you how to create cylinders. To activate the cylinder tool, I will click on the arrow below the box tool in the home ribbon. Otherwise, you can type cylinder in the command line and press enter. Once the command is active, AutoCAD displays the message specify center point of base, so I will click on a random point to define it. Next, I have to specify the base radius, so I will type 5 and press enter. Finally, I need to specify the height. If you don't know the exact height of the cylinder, you can just click to define it. However, in this example, I will type 10 and press enter. Notice how easily I created a solid cylindrical object. Now, I will show you a few more methods of creating cylinders. I will activate the cylinder tool again. And this time, I will create a cylinder using three points to define its base. For this reason, from the options that appear in the command line, I will select the three-point option. Once I select this method, I will click on the three points I have created to specify the first, second, and third points respectively. Once I have specified the three points, another method prompts me to specify the height. If you take a look at the command line, you will see that we are given a few methods for defining the height too. From these options, I will select the axis endpoint option to define the axis towards which I will define the height. In this example, I will click in the x-axis direction and then type the exact height, which is 15, and press Enter. The next method of creating a cylinder is by defining its base with two points. So I will activate the cylinder tool again, and from the options that appear in the command line, I will select the two-point option. Then I will click on the two points I have created to specify the first and second points respectively. This time, to specify the height, I will select the two-point method. This method is very useful if you do not know the exact height, but you have another object that you can use as a reference. If, for example, I want the cylinder to have the same height as the box, I can select the base of the box first, and then click on one of its top corners to define the second point. Notice that indeed, the cylinder and the box have the same height. At this point, I will activate the cylinder tool one more time to create a cylinder using the tan-tan radius option. With this option, the cylinder will be tangent to two objects that I will define, while I can also specify the radius. So I will click on the base of the first cylinder to specify a point on the object for the first tangent. Next, I will click on the base of the second cylinder to specify a point on the object for the second tangent. Then I will type 2.5 to specify the radius and press Enter. Finally, I will type 4 to specify the height of the cylinder and press Enter again. In the tan-tan radius option, if the radius of the cylinder's base is smaller than the distance between the two cylinders, then the command will deactivate automatically and no cylinder will be created. Last but not least, I will activate the cylinder tool one last time to show you how you can create an elliptical cylinder. So from the options that appear in the command line, I will select the elliptical option. Then, I will click to specify the endpoint of the first axis. Next, I need to specify the other endpoint of the first axis. In this case, I will move the cursor to the right, type the number 5, and press Enter. Now, I have to specify the endpoint of the second axis, so I will move the cursor upward, type the number 1, and press Enter again. At last, to specify the height, I will type 3 and press Enter. Notice the final result.